What is dark matter and why the universe behaves in the way it behaves is one of the big open questions that has actually no good answer right now. We don't really know much of what dark matter is made of. My name is Javier Tiffenberg and I'm associate scientist at Fermilab. What I do at Fermilab is essentially to try to develop new kinds of sensors that are extremely, extremely sensitive. And then we use those sensors to answer important questions in physics, like what is dark matter, or what's the true nature of neutrinos, or other things about the quantum world. I work in many experiments related to CCDs. A CCD is essentially a sensor that can be used to detect many kinds of particles. They are mostly used as imaging detectors to form an image in digital cameras. In that case, they are detecting photons that are the particles that make up light. The Skipper CCD is very similar to a regular CCD with one important difference. That is, the CCD is a perfect CCD in the sense that it has no noise. So whatever single piece of light or single photon that gets to the CCD, you will record it and you will only record that and you will never generate noise. The Skipper CCD can be used as a very sensitive particle detector. So whenever a particle travels through the sensor, it produces some what we call ionization, that is, it deposits energy, and then that produces some electrons that we can record. That's the way all the digital cameras work. But that not only happens when light goes through the CCD or the sensor, it also happens when other particles go through this, like electrons, muons, protons, cosmic rays, and many, many other things. So what we are trying to do with these CCDs that are extremely sensitive and have no noise is to take the darkest pictures ever and to see in these pictures the interactions of some exotic particles like dark matter or some very elusive particles like neutrinos. The Skipper CCD opens a new window in looking for dark matter because it allows us to look for very light dark matter candidates that we weren't able to look or before. What I like about working at Fermilab is that essentially whatever engineering problem you can think of, someone at Fermilab has already solved it. So you just need to find the right person. So having the opportunity to interact with all these people that have this huge amount of experience in many, many different areas and that they are able to produce and solve problems that you didn't even think that might exist, that's the best thing about working at Fermilab.